Hello guys, welcome to RAM structural system video tutorials. In this video tutorial we will continue where we ended in the last video tutorial. So we'll discuss about grid lines. Let's get started. So I'm in modeler over here and I already have a level 2 and a roof level created over here. Let me add a ground level as well. So I'm gonna go over here in layout, say type, I'll be saying select, and then over here I'll add, let's say ground. Level, I'll say add and I'll select that. Alright, so now we are in selected ground level. However, we need to assign a story height to it. So I'm gonna go to story here. I'm gonna set this as my level number 1. I'll select ground level. Floor to floor height will be 15 feet. Actually, floor to floor height will be 2 feet. So this is when you assign height over here, it's basically looking from that level downward. So I'm assuming like there's gonna be some kind of you know, grid beams and all those in those 2 feet 24 inches. So I'm gonna say ground floor. Like you'll see it once we get started on the modeling what I mean by this 2 feet and 15 feet over here. So this 15 feet is when you're looking at level 2 and measuring from bottom of level 2, sorry, top of level 2 to the top of ground floor. However, this 2 feet is from top of ground floor to the base, basically. Let me add that. Alright, so 1, 2, 3. That's alright. Select OK now. So now let's get started on the grid lines. So once I go over here in layout, I see grids over here. I can say create slash edit. Let me select that. And I'll give my grid label system a label naming to it. So let me say grid system 1. So I'm gonna I want a orthogonal grid system over here, no offsets. I'm gonna talk about these offsets and these radial grid system in a bit. So let's add that. And now once you add it, you need to select it and you need to edit grids, and then you can add your X and Y grids over here. So let's say I want to add a grid label A, and my spacing, I want it to be 20 feet and I want like 10 grids. So I'm going to add 10 over here and I'm going to say add. So I'm going to get A, B, C, D, F, G, H, I, J, K, like 10 grids with 20 feet on grid spacing. So similarly, I'm gonna try Y. I'm gonna call it out as 1 over here. Grid spacing will be 25. Let's go with number of grids as 10. Select add, and you're gonna add 10 grids. So they are spaced at 25 foot on center. Your units are in feet, and for instance, let's say you want to move this grid line number 11 by another 10 feet away. So I'm going to add 10 feet over here and say move. So it goes to 260 feet now. So if you want to move it, you can do that, or you can edit it yourself. Like, so 225, if you want to change it to 230, you change that to 230 and say change over here. So it gets changed to 230. Alright, so now once you say select OK, make sure you select OK. Do not do cancel or escape out of it, because you lose all the saving, all the grid lines that you saved. So select OK. Now, since you cannot see the grid lines, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go to layout back over here. I'm gonna go to grids. I'm gonna go to select over here. And for ground level, I'm going to select grid system 1 and select OK. So now I can see my grid system. All right. Now, let's look into other grids. So go to create or edit. All right. So let's have a grid system number 2, and it is orthogonal. It is offset by 25 feet in x direction and another 50 feet in y direction. And if you want rotation, you can keep rotation of 45 degrees or whatever your project requires. And you select add. Now you go to edit grids and make sure you give some unique grid labels to these. I'm gonna say spacing at 15 feet on center. I'm just gonna add 4 grids because I just want to show you what all we can do in here. So in along Y, I'm gonna add label 1 1, spacing I'm gonna keep same, 5 grids, 5 additional grids, select add. Okay, we have our grids. Now select OK, same thing, select OK over here. You're not gonna see that grid line system because it's not yet selected. So go back to layout, go back to grids, say select, and now you have your grid system 2. So you can select grid system 2 and you can say okay. So as you can see, your grid system 2 is offset in x and y directions by, I think it was 25 feet. Let me go back and check that. So yeah, as you can see, in x direction it's 25 feet and in y direction it's 50 feet, and then the rotation is 45 degrees. If I do rotation 0 degrees and say change, you can still change that way and select OK. Now it will ask you to make sure that if you wanna, you know, like, are these the final changes, because it's gonna save the model for you and you cannot go back once it's saved. So I'm gonna say save the changes. I'm fine with it. So as you can see, my grid lines are offset in x and y direction. Now you are not able to see it. You can see it like it's starting from 0 and 0, but let me show you. Once if I select both the grid systems, the offset is clearly visible. Select OK. So now as you can see, my offset is clearly visible. 25 feet in x direction and 50 feet in y direction. So let me go ahead and I guess remove one of the systems. I'm gonna remove system number 2 since I don't need it. I was just showing it to you guys. Select OK. Let's talk about a radial grid system. So go to create or edit, and let me name this as grid system number 3, say radial, and now I'm gonna say add. Same thing applies when you do offset and rotation. So let's go to grid system 3, select edit grids, and for this, let's start with grid label Z. And angle increment of, let's say 10 degrees. I want 5 additional grids and say add. So now as you can see, you're gonna get 5 additional grids starting from 0. You can change these labels as needed. All right, let's go to circular grid. So I'm gonna say this one will be, let's say, AAA, or you can say AB. and radial increment, I'm gonna say 10 feet. Number of grids will be 5, select add. I did something wrong. Let's do this. AAA, select add. Okay, now that works. As you can see, radial distance, like, it's in feet. And another thing about these labels, now if you want to see label in I and J, both the directions, so you need to select both the grids whenever you are inputting those grid lines. So right now, as you can see, label I is yes and label J is no. So it's not going to show you grid line on the other side. It's going to show you grid line on the only on one side. Select OK. Select OK. Now let's go and select that grid line system for our ground floor and see how it shows. So as you can see, like at angles of 10 degrees, and then a radial distance of 10 feet on center. So like you, like there might be rarely some scenarios where you may need radial grids. However, most of the time it's orthogonal grids or orthogonal grids at an offset angle increment. So let me go back over here. Let me select the select grid system one, select OK. Now as I can see my grid system. Let me go back to grids. Now if I don't need a grid, like you can delete it, the whole system, in case you don't need it. So most of the cases, like you only need like orthogonal grid system with just a rotation sometimes, or else it's always 90 degrees or 0 degrees. Alright, let's talk about construction grids. So there are shortcuts over here, like to edit grid systems. Directly you can click on this icon over here, edit grid systems, or you have select grid systems over here, which you can select whichever you want for your particular floor level. And then you have construction grids. So construction grids, like in case whenever you are around 75% construction design phase and you have added a new column at some distance from so and so grid, and you don't want to add that grid, you can add a construction grid. So let me show you how to do that. You can click on this construction grid. Now it will give you multiple options, like if you want it parallel to a beam, like for instance you have a beam that you need to model parallel to so and so beam, and you want a grid line along that beam, you can add a construction grid for that. Or so in this case, like in order to add a construction grid, like you have different modes, like this over here, it's parallel to beam or wall, which since we do not have any beams, you're not going to use that. We are going to go with parallel to grid for now. So let's say parallel to grid, I want at 5 feet. So I'm going to say add, I'm going to select my grid. So as you can see, it's showing on this side as well as on this side, left and right side. So I'm going to select right side, and as you can see my construction grid like on the right side, and it extends over the boundaries, but that is fine. Now, I mean, whenever you are in a time constraint, whenever you have less time, you can use construction grids rather than going back and adding new grids wherever you need it. So construction grids, let's see what other options we have for construction grids. So point and angle. So you can add at a so and so distance and at whatever degrees, for instance 5 degrees, let's say. Select add. So if you select, let's say I select this point, it's gonna show me in 4 directions from that point at 5 foot on center. And then you have 2 points option. So let's say add, you need to select 2 points, and then it's gonna show you along that. along those two points. So let's say I added this point and that, so it's gonna give me along that angle. Control Z still works in here. So let me take that off. Okay, fine. I don't need this construction grid as well, so I'm gonna remove that. So you can say construction grids, delete single, and select on that. So it will delete that construction grid. And you also have delete all options. So like if you have a bunch of construction grids, you can say delete all and it will delete all the construction grids in your whole ground level layout. I think that was all for this video. Like, we do not have anything else in this video. So that is how you create grid systems for your project in RAM structural system. Let me know if you have any questions in the comments below. Please subscribe for more videos. Hope to see you soon. We'll discuss about beams in next video tutorials. Thank you.